At the national level, thousands of 17-year-old girls like yourselves compete around the country in places like
beautiful Mount Rose, Minnesota,
and make it all the way here to Lincoln, Alabama, to compete for the title of American Teen Princess. So which one of you will it be?
Like sands through the hourglass, so are the days of our lives.
God, Iris, you taped your shoes over it.
Now, ladies, the rest of the tape, which is now gone forever, goes on about starting that great journey, which we call the American Teen Princess Pageant. So any of you young ladies who'd like to start on that journey, you just come right down here and sign up. And please help yourself to some coffee and bars. Showtime.
Do you think that most people would say that teenage beauty pageants are a good idea?
Oh, yeah, sure. I know what some of your big city no-bra-wearing, hairy-legged women libbers might say. They might say that a pageant is old-fashioned and demeaning to the girls.
Yeah. What sick is women dressing like men?
Oh, you yes, betcha, Iris. Indeed. No, I think you boys are going to find something a little bit different here in Montrose. Mm-hmm. For one thing, we're all God-fearing folk, mm-hmm. every yes. last one of us. Mm-hmm. And you will not find a back room in our video store.
No,
no, no, that filth is better left to the Sin Cities.
A.K.A. Minneapolis, St. Paul.
Today's to-do list includes a trip to the Mall of America, where we are going to be buying outfits for the physical fitness number.
Yeah, nothing too showy.
No, you betcha, Iris. We need that third judge. Oh, gosh, don't let me forget. We need to think of a theme.
Guys, look out!
Oh! Gosh, darn it! Hello, Father Dunnigan. Sidewalks? Sidewalks? Iris, stop it. It's not his fault. The communal wine just proves too tempting for some of them.
That's why we Lutherans use grape Kool-Aid for the blood of Christ. Oh, there's a parking space over there. Oh, no, that's just a compact. Sorry.
You'd think they'd have the parking lot of America to go with the Mall of America.
It's a $200 fine.
I told you I would move the car if a cripple came. Now just run in the store and pick out some outfits.
All right, let's go.
Wait. I think I just thought of the theme. Oh, proud to be an American.
So, what was the theme of the pageant last year?
Oh, that was by American.
And the year before that was?
USA is A-OK.
And can you remember the theme of your favorite pageant?
Can I? Amer, I can. People ask me where I get this. I don't know, it's maybe a gift from God or something. Oh, yeah, sure, you know, every pageant is special. But this one is extra super special to me. When I was 17, I don't know if you know this, but I was crowned Montrose's American Teen Princess. And this year, drum roll please, my lovely daughter, Rebecca Ann Lehman, is competing.
Is this my mark? Hi, I'm Rebecca Lehman, and I believe this pageant is an important experience for every young woman. It teaches you what's really important in life, and it has the power to change you in ways you've never dreamed of. My mom gave me this 9mm for my 13th birthday. Yeah, I always remember what she wrote in the card. Jesus loves winners. That's why no matter what I do, I aim to win.
I beg your pardon. Would you like a drink?
Impartial? When I'm outside these walls, I am Gladys Lehman, President, Civil Servettes. Impartial as the day is long. But I'm in my house now, and I gotta warn you, I'm wearing my wife apron and my mom hat. So I can safely say that I am the mother of the most talented contestant Montrose has ever had. Oh gosh, you know, she's been singing and dancing since she was just knee-high to a pig's eye.